Corey Cohen, Vice President of Marketing at TBI, and I'm here with Patrick Russell at 8x8. Patrick, what do you do?
I'm the Director of Product Marketing for CCAS at 8x8.
That's cool.
It's really cool.
Tell me a little bit about the 8x8 CCAS offering.
You know, it's really interesting. 8x8 offers a contact center product that packs in more capabilities than anybody else in the industry. I've been in the space 17 years, and I've not seen quite as much value packed in at this price point across the board, hands down, no doubt.
So how do you explain go-to-market, your differentiation?
Sure. Because we own so many different pieces of technology, we have greater flexibility over the pricing and the ability to scale by adding on more components than anybody else in the space. We're dependent on third-party tech or integrations here and there as much as everyone else is. So it gives us a lot more control than what you'll see everywhere else.
Okay, but speaking about third-party integrations,
what
is the 8x8 CCAS play? How do you integrate with third-party tech?
So we have a pretty extensive list of CRMs that we've already pre-integrated with, but we also have what's called our dynamic integration framework, and that really enables us to integrate with other systems that aren't necessarily pre-built at a rapid pace. So instead of taking 60, 90 days to integrate, we can do this in less than a month, you know, a couple days or weeks instead of months.
Okay, yeah. Cool. What is a typical 8x8 customer for CCAS?
You know, it's an interesting question. So we don't have seat minimums. So it can be as little as you can find, and it can scale up to really, really big size, large scale contact centers. I would say our sweet spot is somewhere between 100 contact center seats up to about 800. Somewhere in that window is where we find a lot of success and have a really high win rate.
So talk to me about what is the 8x8 ideal customer?
Yeah, so I would say that it's any contact center less than 800 seats. That's really where we have the highest win rate. We can support deals that are much, much bigger in the multi-thousands, but really that 0 to 800 space, we have a very, very, very good success track record.
As Jim says, like the play on the 8x8, 8 to 800 seats, yeah.
We can go with that, actually. I like that. 8 to 800 is the perfect range for us.
Cool.
Yeah.
Where's your platform hosted?
So we actually have 17 global data centers. So we are a true global provider. We have 20 offices, 17 data centers. We have headquarter offices in Singapore with some of our subsidiary brands, London, United Kingdom, of course, San Jose, Minneapolis, New York, all over the place. But 17 data centers globally.
And support plans. So we sell it and they need help.
It's a great question. So support is really where the rubber meets the road. And 8x8 does something that's unique in that we offer follow-the-sun support model separate from your dedicated assigned account manager. And what makes follow-the-sun different is that it allows us to work a single case or single issue 24/7. So follow-the-sun means that wherever the sun is, in essence, that case can be handed off to the next group to keep working urgent issues. It's not something you'll see across the other CCAS providers.
Is that a fancy way for saying outsourced?
It's not outsourced. It's all in-house. We don't outsource our support.
So, Patrick, tell me what's on the horizon with AI and R&D. What's 8x8 up to with your CCAS platform?
All kinds of things, but specific to analytics is where I'll start. So we include customer experience analytics with every contact center purchase. It's just included. And what we're doing with that particular piece is we're adding more next best action or suggestive coaching tips to the supervisors so they can say, meet with agent XYZ to talk about this given metric. And then it also automatically provides the tracking of seeing if they're improving or not to continue to give coaching guidance to management so that they're not really having to hunt and fish through data to figure out what they need to focus on.
Very cool.
Some of the other things regarding AI is we have new self-service capabilities that are already out there. We have agent assistance, which is now in the beta state, soon to be released. And we're going to continue kind of building on how to better arm the agents so they have more information more readily available to really improve the customer experience.
Yeah, now it's not just about the customer experience, it's about the employee experience and how to connect the two. So it seems like 8x8 is doing their fair share to make sure that both are cohesive.
Totally true. We are an agent-centric shop, agent-first. And in fact, one of the things that everyone can look forward to is we're working on our new agent interface, which we'll be demoing at Enterprise Connect in 2020. And you'll be able to really see how an agent-first collaborative contact center is different. It's really exciting.
I look forward to it.
Yeah, I can't wait to show it to you.
Awesome. TBI and 8x8, thank you so much.
Thanks.
They're not even going to use that part.
Yeah, we're not going to use that. Awesome.